Heading out on our adventure today, and it is snowing outside. What?
Lock the door.
You say you're having fun? Oh, good. We're in the gondola. She's loving it because the wind is blowing this thing everywhere.
It's over.
Yeah. Should have videoed while we was out in the middle. Pretty neat. To get to get them slowed down by crowds and can't find the right kind of food to eat, but we'll get there eventually. Mount Rainier and surrounded by rivers. The valley is full of evergreens. Well, we made it to the end of the road. We're at the paradise area. And it looks like paradise. Mount Rainier. We'll walk up there in a few minutes. Yeah. The Paradise Inn. It's not open right now, but that's the Paradise Inn, which is kind of cool to stay there. Here's the mountains surrounding Rainier. And this is the Vista Center here at Paradise Inn. Some weirdos brought their dogs, of course. Beautiful mountain. I think that's Narada Falls. On a lot of these bases, there's just so many cool things that you could just look at for days. I mean, out here at McCord Field, they have all of these airplanes sitting here. I haven't taken the time, but it's the Airfield Museum, and there's a plaque by every one of these airplanes. I wonder if it tells a story, if they were actually in combat. The stories that these old airplanes could tell. It's really something. You got a Canadian jet there. Look at this big old thing here. Now that is a unique looking airplane. Really something. Really enjoy these trips.
Fan of the TV show The Deadliest Catch, this is a good time of year to try and look for those fishing boats that may be in town right now. They are real working fishing boats, so I never know when they're going to be in harbor or when they're out fishing. But if you are a fan of The Deadliest Catch, I'll tell you when to start looking for those boats.
I'm a fan.
Off to the right hand. Why'd they build it like this? Why is the ramp so steep to get down to the boat? If you came back here in 6 hours, that ramp would be exactly level and you would just walk straight across, because the boat and the pier are floating on the water, and then up on the land it's a stable level. And so as the tide goes down, the boat goes down, and as the tide goes up, it goes up. So that means we get pretty big tidal changes, and so really interesting animals can be found in those intertidal zones as well. Just above the construction barge off connecting downtown to the waterfront, they didn't actually choose to tear the viaduct down because they wanted to put up the rocky beaches of the coast and then the forested area in between. So the idea is you get to experience Washington State. Scandinavian names. Sometimes these guys will be in the parade.
Thank you.
Almost every fishing boat that fishes in the Bering Sea fishes in the summertime because it has calm waters, long daylight hours, and warmer temperatures. Thank you. actually out at sea. There is a huge size difference between a crab fishing boat like you see on the right and this huge blue white boat that we're seeing on the left with all the horses. The reason why this blue and white boat on the left is so large is about what type of fish they're trying to catch. They're going after a fish called pollock. And for years and years and years, if a fisherman caught pollock in his net, he would immediately throw it back into the ocean because pollock would spoil before they could get it to the processing plant. And if you put it in the hold of your ship, not only would the pollock spoil, it would spoil all the other fish that you had caught. So they would throw it back. One summer, there was a guy from back east who got a summer job. The largest shipyard company on the west coast, off to the right hand side, this is Foss Shipyards. They are doing some work on an enormous fishing boat on the right, and because this is also the migration route of the salmon, the exact same time.
Looks like the Great Bridge first, but I could be wrong. It's an optical illusion.
See a green and yellow building will be packed. 30 feet off the water. Our boat is 34 feet tall. We figured something out that instead of waiting for the bridge to open, we can fold down the flag and the antennas on top of our boat. And if we aim for dead center, which is the highest span of this bridge, we can slip under with a good few inches to spare. So that is what we're about to do right now as we go underneath the Fremont Drawbridge. Take the house out for a day on the lake. They're under a completely different category than houseboats, and I would say the most meaningful one is that once you buy a boat, every year you get your value slowly depreciates a little bit, as opposed to a floating home. If you own one of these floating homes, you can take a look at that. Own a floating home, it's like you own the mud under the lake, and yes, you do pay property taxes on that, but you actually own real estate, and the number of lots for floating homes is limited to 5 lots to industrial museum. The parts are labeled, you can walk through and see how the factory used to work.
Does it get any more Seattle than this? I'm drinking Starbucks coffee, right next to the water, right next to the Ferris wheel. Yeah, I'm on the docks, Seattle, drinking coffee. This is as Seattle as you can get.